Hi guys, welcome back to SHK Excel World. I am Sarin Heather and we have been going on with our series on financial modeling with SHK Excel World. In our first video, we talked about the four basic principles or guidelines given by the FAST standard organization on financial modeling. So this is also not a sponsored video from FAST organization. For knowledge purposes, we talked about those four principles. So your financial model should be flexible, appropriate, structured, and transparent. So if you still want to know as to what these terms mean, go and check out my first video. The link is given above and also in the description below. So going forward in today's video, we will talk about the actual rules of the game. So this is not a general thing. We will actually explore as to how different elements of your financial model should be produced or given in your Excel workbook. So whether it is the workbook itself or is a worksheet or is your cell or actual contents of the financial model. So this video will be divided into all of these three parts. So while making this video, if we feel that the video is getting longer, I will break this video into two parts and you will see the rest of the elements in the next video. So before moving on, do not forget to subscribe to SHK Excel World and also share this video with all of your friends who want to learn financial modeling from scratch but at a standard level. So guys, this is a file which we are going to use today and this is slightly different from the one we used in our first video, because that was an incomplete financial model but sufficient for a requirement then. But you will be pleased to know that this is a fully functioning complete financial model with financial statements. So you can see that you can easily maneuver the tenure of the financial model. You can opt for one of the options or the scenarios and your results, charts and everything will change. So this will help you to learn as to how the complete cycle of the financial model works, and I have tried to make it as simple as possible. There are no complexities because we will be learning these complexities in future and how to deal with them. So in future, I will also try to make one video just to describe this complete cycle so that you understand fully. So coming on to today's exercise, where we wanted to learn all of the three elements of the financial model, the first one being the workbook itself. So the standard or the best practices always guide you that you should prepare your financial model in a single workbook. And why is it so? Because when you are sharing your financial model, which is based on more than one workbook, on an email, then there are chances and likelihood that your links are going to get disturbed. And after that, it will be next to impossible to correct those links between the multiple workbooks. So it is always advisable to prepare your financial model, complete financial model in one workbook. And if you have a valid reason to break your financial model into more than one workbook, then you should define color codes for two types of cells. First one is where the data is being imported from another workbook. So it should have, all of those cells should have one color. And the second one is all of those cells which are exporting data to another workbook. So all of those cells should have one color. And both of these color codes should be defined in your first sheet, which contains all of the color codes, which I will tell you later on. So this is the color coding. And you have to define all of those color codes here so that the user understands that there is something which is coming from outside this workbook. So coming on to the second element of the financial model, which is the worksheet. So a basic financial model has a basic set of worksheet. So if you talk about this financial model, it is a very basic and simple financial model. It has your first sheet, which defines the color code and the instructions for the user. And then it defines, it has a sheet for assumptions, then revenue, debt, statements, financial statements. And then the final sheet, which contains the data on which your dashboard or graphs are based on. So this basic set of sheets is colored in a particular way. So you can see the dark blue color here. So other set of sheets can be your dashboard or graph sheet, which contains different analysis for the user, then the evaluation sheet, and then the sensitivity analysis sheet, and so on. So these can be another set of sheet, and those can be colored in a different way. So those color codes should also be defined here. Secondly, your sheet should be arranged in a way that your data flow is from left to right. So if you talk about this particular financial model, it starts with the first sheet is for the instructions or for the rules. Then it goes on to the assumptions. So the first sheet is assumptions, which contains the raw data, which is being exported to the next worksheets. Then you have the revenue, and then you have the debt, and ultimately the financial statements, which contain all of the working from the previous sheets, and finally the control sheet or the sheet which makes the basis for our dashboard. So this is how our data is flowing from left to right. So another sheet which is very important and is most neglected in preparing financial models is the instruction sheet or the color coding sheet. So at the minimum, it should tell the user as what the financial model contains. It contains this sheet and is used for this purpose, and this sheet and used for this purpose, and it also has the color of the sheet tab. So the next element is the color code. It defines the color code for different cells. So it tells as to what is the color of the cell and what it means. Like the green colored cells are the input cells. Like if you go on to the assumption sheet, all of the green colored cells are hard coded because these are input cells. And beside that, the instructions are given that it's a percentage or it's a date or it's a value. And what you have to do, you have to select like this, or you have to write in or punch in some figures. So all of the instructions should be very clear in your financial model. So the cells which are not colored and have black font are the cells which contain formulas, and those should not be changed. It's clearly mentioned here. If we go on to our working sheets, you can see all of the cells which contain formula. If I open the formula bar here, you can see all of these contain formulas. So everything is linked from a different sheet, and we should not change these cells or modify the formula until unless there is an error in it. So it is defined here clearly. Then we have the headers. So all of the headers have a particular color. So these are the two things we talked about earlier, that all of the cells which contain data imported from another workbook should be colored red. So this is one way of defining the color code. And all of the cells who are exporting data to another workbook are colored blue. And the same thing is defined on the right side. Then all of the worksheets should have a particular structure to it, like we talked about in our first video, that like coming on to the revenue sheet. So this is a gross revenue working section. And then each section is divided into different paragraphs or sub calculation groups. So those have a particular color, and this also has dark blue color. And same theme is being followed all across the working. And if there is something which is incomplete, or you are still working on it, or trying to figure out a simple formula, you can define a color for that. Or if something is confusing for you and you want to refer it to another user before sending the financial model, you can define the color code and then send the same. Like this is another working which has been colored yellow, just to tell that this is a temporary working and I will delete it afterwards, or I want to share it with another user and I will tell that please check this working. So the user will directly go on to that color coded cell and change the working. And then at the minimum, the financial model or this particular sheet should define as to how the financial model is working. And if the user wants to make any correction or modifications or changes into your financial model, then what is the proper way of doing it? Like it defines that if the user wants to add another product into it, if we go on to the revenue sheet, so we can see that there are products up to E. So, 5 products. So, if the user wants to add another product, so what is the procedure for that? And coming on to the options, if the user wants to add another option into your financial model, then what is the procedure? So, this will protect your financial model as a whole from doing wrong calculation. So, uniformity is another hallmark of a good financial model. And if we see all of these working sheets like the revenue, debt, financial statements and even control, you can see easily that the first 4 lines are left for giving heading of any sort. F5 cell of each working sheet contains the first year or the first period of your financial model. So wherever the user sees a reference to F5 of any working sheet, the user will easily know that this is the first year of the financial model. So your working sheets should be uniform all across your financial model. And now, so we normally see that the working sheets are more than 1 page long, and if you scroll down, your headers are hidden. So I can freeze it here, just below the headers, select the cell, go to view, and then freeze panes here. So this is the best place for freezing your working sheet. Then what it will do is that whenever you are working in your working sheet, in your financial model, so this whole area is available to you. And if you want to produce any error checks, so this will always be visible to you if you are making any changes to the financial model, and the error will pop up here. Or there is another place for producing the error checks. You can produce it right at your dashboard where you are manipulating the financial model, and this is a check for the balance sheet if it is balanced or not. So if I go to the balance sheet and make an error, intentional error, so your error check will prompt you that there is an error, there is one error, and you have to modify or make changes or see what the last changes you have done because of which there is an error in your financial model. And this error can be placed just above the freezing pane so that it is always visible to you. So in addition to your financial model being uniformly presented, your data should be presented horizontally, because we know that the financial model tenure can go up to, let's say, 25 years or 30 years at max, but your elements or the calculations are much more than that. So guys, as the video has gone longer, I think it is necessary that we cut off it here and do the rest of the things in our next video. So if you have any questions which are unanswered up till now, so you can comment me and ask those questions, and I will try to answer those questions in the upcoming videos. And till the next video, bye-bye.